A topic that often shows up on the FAA Part 107 exam is loading. The FAA wants you to know how much weight you can load before an aircraft starts to fly in an unsafe manner. Material in this tutorial is similar to that in the study guide I used to pass the FAA Part 107 exam with a 90% score. Also, there are many other YouTube tutorials I made to help you prepare for the exam. I linked these resources in the description and above. There are several concepts important for the topic of loading. First is the center of gravity. In theory, the center of gravity is the point at which the entire mass of an object concentrates. You can think of it as a point at which you can attach a line and suspend an object, such as an aircraft, in balance. The center of gravity of an aircraft may change. The typical reason for this is loading or releasing items from the aircraft. For instance, if you attach an extra battery to the drone, this will shift the location of the center of gravity. The next notion is the datum, or reference datum. It refers to an imaginary vertical line on an aircraft. You use datum to calculate balance and the center of gravity. The aircraft manufacturer manual will specify how to find the location of the datum. The datum's location doesn't change. Next is the notion of arm or moment arm. The arm is the horizontal distance from the datum to the center of gravity of an object loaded to the aircraft. The arm measurement is given in inches and it can be positive or negative. If you have an object to the aft or the rear of the aircraft, it will have a positive value. If the arm is measured to the front of the aircraft, it has a negative value. If you think about it, this makes sense. Items attached to the opposite side of the aircraft's center of gravity will balance each other out, so you need to somehow account for that with negative and positive values. The final important concept to understand is moment. The moment refers to the turning effect of the force coming from an attached object on the aircraft. This force, in our case, is the gravity force of an object. You compute the moment of an object as its mass multiplied by its arm. Thus, heavier objects with longer arms will have larger moments. Whenever you attach something to your drone, you need to always keep the moment of an object in mind. If the moment is too large, it can destabilize and spin your drone out of control. In aviation, the center of gravity is expressed in inches from the aircraft's datum. You can compute the center of gravity by dividing the aircraft's total moment by its total weight. The allowed range for the center of gravity will be specified in the pilot operating handbook or drone's flight manual. Let's go over an example of how you can calculate an aircraft's center of gravity in real life. Consider an aircraft with a certain empty weight. The empty weight can include the aircraft's frame, fixed equipment, seats, and any fuel that cannot be used. Let's suppose the empty weight of the aircraft is 2,100 pounds with an arm of 78.3 inches from the datum. The manufacturer's documentation should provide the aircraft's empty weight and its specifications. Next, we have rear and front human occupants and luggage with their respective weights and arms. The first step is to multiply the weight of each item by its arm. Next, compute the total weight and the total moment of all items on the aircraft by summing them up. The center of gravity will equal to the moment of 281,430 pound-inches divided by the total weight of 3,320 pounds. The result of 84.8 inches from the datum is where the center of gravity will be located. Suppose the manufacturer specified the aircraft's maximum weight of 3,400 pounds. Also, the allowed distance range for the center of gravity from the datum is 78 to 86 inches. In our case, the launch weight and the center of gravity meet the manufacturer's guidelines. If not, the aircraft can be unstable and uncontrollable under certain circumstances. The next notion is balance. In aviation, balance refers to where an aircraft's center of gravity is located. Balance plays a key role in stability. There are two axes along which we can determine the aircraft's balance. The first type of balance is the longitudinal balance. It refers to where the center of gravity will be located along the aircraft's fuselage. This is also known as the center of gravity along the longitudinal axis. If the center of gravity location is too far back or forward, the aircraft can be unstable. This means that it will be subject to strong pitching forces, tilting it forward or back. You want your aircraft's primary controls to be able to counter this pitching. If not, the flight becomes dangerous. The pilot must consider shifting items on board so that the center of gravity is within the allowed limits. Next is the lateral balance. The lateral balance refers to the aircraft's ability to keep its wings even along the lateral axis. If one wing is heavier than the other one, the center of gravity along the lateral axis will be such that the lateral balance will be compromised. In this case, the aircraft will be experiencing banking or rolling force, tilting it out of balance. If the pilot is unable to counter this imbalance with the aileron control, the flight becomes dangerous. The pilot's primary concern is the longitudinal balance, while the lateral balance comes second. I made a tutorial where I explain in detail an aircraft's controls, axis of rotation, balance, and stability. I link this tutorial above and in the description. Let's test your understanding of weight and balance. The first question tests your understanding of balance. For a pilot, the drone's balance is priority number one. Every time you attach extra objects to the drone, the center of gravity changes. If it changes to the point outside of the allowed range, the aircraft can become unstable. This makes choice B the answer. This question wants to know where you can find the limits for the center of gravity. Recall, the center of gravity limits are measured in inches from the aircraft's datum. The pilot's operating handbook or the drone's flight manual will provide the maximum allowed range. This makes choice B the answer to this question. This question wants to know the consequences of operating a drone with a weight above its limit. Excessive weight will adversely affect the drone's control. Choices B and C are wrong because they refer to the opposite of that. Putting too much weight on a drone will reduce its endurance. Endurance refers to the maximum length of time a drone can spend on a cruising flight. This makes choice A the answer. This question inquires of how recent weight and balance measurement should be. The FAA requires that they must be as current as possible. This makes choice A the answer. The fifth question wants to know which statement is true with regards to weight and balance. Choice A is incorrect. The center of gravity of a drone can indeed change during the flight. This can happen as a result of burning fuel or dropping an object. Choice B is incorrect too. The lateral center of gravity is important to operating drones. Recall, lateral balance refers to how even the aircraft's wings are. Thus, the answer is choice C. If you load too much stuff on your drone, this may upset its control. The next question tests your knowledge of longitudinal balance. If the center of gravity is located too far back of the aircraft, this will produce upward pitching force. The pilot controls the aircraft's pitching motion with elevator. If the elevator cannot counter the moment from the most rearward center of gravity, the flight is unstable at all speeds. This makes choice A the answer. This question tests the formula for calculating the center of gravity. Recall, the formula for the center of gravity is the aircraft's total moment divided by its total weight. This makes choice A the answer to this question. This question tests the definition of the arm. If you attach an object to the aircraft, the arm is the distance from the object's center of gravity to the aircraft's datum. This makes choice C the answer to this question. This question tests your knowledge of moment and its formula. The moment of an object attached to the aircraft is calculated as its weight multiplied by its arm. In our case, it is 300 pounds multiplied by the arm of 100 inches. This produces the moment of 30,000 pound inches, making choice A the answer to this question. This is it for today's tutorial. In my next FAA Part 107 exam tutorial, I will cover load factor and stalls of aircrafts. In the meantime, feel free to ask questions if you want to clarify the material covered in this video. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. We will have more tutorials that will help you prepare for the FAA Part 107 exam. We also regularly post travel guides and photography tutorials. Thanks for watching.